great changes have been made since the turn of the 21st century, especially the revolutionary development brought by ICT converged technologies. It seems that we just stepped in the PC era yesterday, and suddenly we are entering the mobile web era today, or specifically, an era of cloud computing and cloud services. In recent years, we have witnessed that cloud computing has spread across the world and directly changed enterprise IT architecture and business models. What are indeed cloud computing and cloud services? What key features do cloud services have? How do they disruptively change the IT world? How and where can we learn the skills of cloud services? Let me take this opportunity to answer them one by one. To answer what cloud services are, let's answer the four questions on the screen first. We will start with the evolution of cloud computing, followed by its definition and features. IT professionals may have noticed that enterprise IT infrastructure becomes more complicated in recent 10 years. This has introduced more problems ever than before. Typical problems include slow service rollout, high total cost of ownership, and I/O bottlenecks. Traditional service rollout process consists of hardware procurement, software installation and deployment, and service commissioning. This long process lasts several weeks to even months. All IT systems need maintenance support. There are many servers in IT systems, and generally, these servers are maintained separately by different technical towers. We call them support silos. When IT services are unavailable, it takes hours or days to restore these services. The business loss is enormous. Additionally, with traditional IT architecture, a physical server often plays a single role, such as a SAP server, an Oracle database server, or a web server. Therefore, specific software uses dedicated hardware. Usage rate is high only during peak hours. Most of the time, the usage rate is nonetheless low, and idle resources cannot be used by other services, unfortunately. It is even harder to estimate the resource requirement and provide proper IT system capacity in IT architecture design. In fact, the provided capacity is either too much or too little. Too little sounds all right because we can expand the capacity, but what if it is too much? Return and refund? It is all but impossible. Capacity expansion is not that optimistic as you may think. Enterprises have fixed budget on their annual IT investment, so they do not have enough money to expand the capacity immediately and need to wait for the next fiscal year. This is the disadvantage of the traditional IT architecture, where the expansion is difficult and lacks elasticity. In a traditional computer system, the CPU I/O is faster than the memory I/O, and the latter is faster than the disk I/O. This creates I/O bottlenecks when data are transmitted in the system. Broadly speaking, system component processing capability imbalance limits the application performance. Because of these I/O bottlenecks and limits, customers can't get the full return of IT investment. To summarize, the traditional IT architecture has three disadvantages. 1. Slow service rollout, long yet complex product life cycle. 2. High TCO. And 3. Key application performance limited by I/O bottlenecks. The traditional IT architecture is incapable to support enterprise-level operation in an efficient manner. There is an urgent need for a new IT revolution. What is this new revolution? Let us check it out next. Since the 1950s of last century, information technologies have developed for over 60 years. In the past, company business ran on mainframes or mid-range computers, and users used terminals to connect them to perform computing tasks. Then, as PCs and x86 servers developed along with the improvement of computing capabilities, users have begun performing computing tasks on their own devices. However, as business complexity and scale grows, the performance of both traditional PCs and servers is increasingly incapable of meeting computing demand. To solve this problem, Huawei migrates servers to the cloud, consolidates all kinds of hardware resources, and uses this unlimited cloud server pool to support business operations. This is cloud computing. The IT world has found itself in another round of convergence, notwithstanding in the cloud this time. So, what is cloud computing indeed? The National Institute of Standards and Technology of America defines cloud computing as a model for enabling convenient, on-demand network access to a shared pool of configurable computing resources, such as networks, servers, storage, applications, and services, that can be rapidly provisioned and released with minimal management effort or service provider interaction. What are cloud services then? In short, cloud services are a variety of cloud computing resources provided over the internet. What are the features of cloud computing? The industry claims that cloud computing is an on-demand self-service with various network access compatibilities. It pools computing, storage, and network resources. This allows it to flexibly scale up and down based on requirements, while charging according to time, traffic, or performance. You can use the web UI to apply for various cloud services in accordance with your resource requirements. For example, ECS allows you to apply for a VM online. You can specify the number of CPUs, memory size, storage capacity, and I/O performance parameters before pressing submit. Then, your required ECS will be created in the cloud backend. The convenience of this process is self-evident. You are allowed to access ECS from home or at work using the internet or VPN, respectively. All the resources used by ECS are logical resources that can be scaled up and down at any time according to your demand. If you are just starting a business, you only need to purchase a few ECS resources at first. You can add resources using auto-scaling as your service requirements grow. In effort to cut cost, you are allowed to decrease ECS resources during off-peak hours. This on-demand resource allocation model saves your money. In this section, we have learned about the background, definition, and basic features of cloud computing. Next, we will introduce Huawei's perspectives on cloud computing and cloud service.